Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about ratios and proportions, a brief review. If you want to write a ratio, like something like our first example, 3 dimes to 4 quarters, you need to change those into the same unit. So I could make 3 dimes into pennies and say that's 30 pennies. I could do 4 quarters as 100 pennies and I could compare 30 to 100. That would work. I could change these into nickels and say this is 6 nickels and this is 20 nickels. Either of those would work, and if I reduce it to lowest terms, I get the same answer. What I decided to do on this one was to change it into dimes. And so I said 3 dimes, and then 4 quarters is 10 dimes, and that's how I got 3 to 10. Whatever comes first goes on top, and second goes on the bottom. And then over here on the second one, I have 4.5 to 12.75. Since 4.5 went first, that went on the top, 4.5, and then 12.75, or 12 and 75 hundredths went on the bottom. Since I have decimals inside of fractions, I need to move that decimal. And so I moved it 2 places because I needed to move this one 2 places. And so when you move that 2 places, you get 450, and when you move this one, you get 1,275. And then how did I get 6/17? Well, in this particular video, I'm not trying to teach you how to reduce fractions. I would say learn to use your calculator to reduce. If you take your calculator and you put 450, I've got a 36X Pro here that I'm using. It's got a fraction button right here, and if you push that, then you get your fraction, and you'd say, okay, 1275, and hit enter, and that would give you 6/17. I don't know what would happen here. I do know what would happen here. Let me show you how to do this on a 30X if you have a TI 30X. So you do 450. I need to turn it on first. 450, and I'd put my division sign over here, and then 1275. Actually, let's try it a better way. Do you see this button here that's a fraction mixed number? Let's try this 450. Then hit that button that tells it that you want it to be a fraction in 1275 and hit enter, and it reduces it for us. So that's a better way. The other way would have worked. It would have gotten a decimal, then I had to change it to a fraction. Better just to go directly there, and that's that really handy fraction button right there. Okay, now I'm going to go on to solving these equations that have proportions in them. A proportion is just when you have 2 ratios that are equal to each other. So you have a left and a right ratio set equal to a proportion. Proportions are something that are covered in a previous class. So this is just a quick review. What you want to do is cross multiply and then divide both sides by a coefficient. So let's take a look at what that means. It's only 2 steps. We're going to cross multiply. That is, I'm going to multiply the numbers that are across from each other. So I'm going to do 4 times 10 and get 40. And on the other direction, I'm going to do x times 5, which we're going to call 5 times x. And that's just written as 5x. So step 1, I multiplied across from each other. And then the coefficient is the number that's multiplying the variable. The coefficient in this problem is 5. So I'm going to divide both sides by 5. Why am I doing that? Well, 5 over 5 will cancel out to 1, which is what I want. And then the other side, 40 divided by 5 is 8. So in 2 steps, I got that answer. I cross-multiplied, and then I divided by the coefficient. Let's try it again. I'm going to do the second problem. I'm going to cross-multiply. 7 times 3 is 21. Doesn't matter which one I do first. I could have done the other one. And y times 10 is 10y. I did this one because the answer doesn't come out to be an exact perfect number, which is good sometimes. And if I then say the coefficient is 10, I divide both sides by 10, and I get y. Now, what people tend to want to do is divide that out and get a decimal answer. And what I'm saying is just leave it. It can't be reduced. It is in lowest terms. It's a simplified fraction. That's a perfectly great answer. If they asked for a decimal, it wouldn't be hard to change that, but I would leave it as a fraction answer. A couple of my letters came off the page here, but you know that says pizza at the end. Let's read through this. If a 12-inch pizza uses 8 ounces of cheese, how much cheese will you need for a 14-inch pizza? Round your answer to the 10th. So let's see what we can do here. What I suggest that you do is off to the side, write the two things that you're comparing. You're comparing the pizza size to the ounces of cheese. You don't have to be that thorough, but I am, but you could just write pizza to cheese or something like that, or size to cheese. And now when I set my proportion up, I want to make sure that always on the top are the size of the pizza, and always on the bottom is the ounces of cheese that we need. So we have a 12-inch pizza that uses 8 ounces of cheese. And then how much will you need? How much cheese will you need? That's what we don't know. We don't know how much cheese. I'm going to call it C. For a 14-inch pizza, so that 14 has to go on top because the pizza size was on the top. So a common mistake for people is to write the wrong thing, like they put 14 on the bottom instead of the top. You won't make that mistake if you take the time to do what I just did and write that way. We're going to solve this the same way. You know, you don't have to be able to do all the multiplication in your head. I can't think what 8 times 14 is. So I'm going to clear this and go 8 times 14. No big deal. I get 112 and just save myself a little time. Use your calculator for things like that. The other direction, 12 times C, I don't need a calculator because I just write those things side by side. What's the coefficient in this problem? The coefficient is 12, so I'm going to divide both sides by 12. And in this case, it says round to the tenth. So it's telling me they want a decimal and they want it rounded to the tenth. So let's take 112 and divide by 12. And then round that to the tenth. Well, do you see how we get 9 and then 3 repeating? If I want to round to the tenth, that's the first 3. The next number is also 3, so it's going to round down. It's not going to go up. It's going to stay as a 3. So rounded, my answer is 9.3. It would take 9.3 ounces of cheese to make that pizza. Okay, last problem. 1 out of 5 cars sold was red. If 6,000 cars were sold, how many of them were red? So what I'm comparing is the total sold to the number of red that were sold. Those are the two things I'm comparing in this problem. And so what I have is 5 cars sold, I had 1 that was red. That's how I have to compare those. And then if 6,000 cars were sold, how many of them were red? I'm going to call that R, because I like R. You can use any letter you want. Now if I cross multiply here, 1,000 times 6 is 6,000 times 1 is 6,000, and 5 times R is 5R. And now I'm going to divide both sides by R. And so I have 6,000 divided by 5. And that gives me 1,200. So that means there were 1,200 cars sold. The two steps, cross multiply and then divide by your coefficient. Those are the only two steps there. Okay, quick review of proportions. Have a fantastic